The James Webb Telescope took the internet by storm last month with its ever so detailed snapshots from space. Our expectations now for every coming space venture have skyrocketed since the James Webb Telescope has set the bars quite high. Surely we had seen space through the lens of the Hubble telescope, but our imagination knows no bounds and is now unstoppable after seeing what we can do with just a telescope after the Webb telescope. The James Webb Telescope has been able to catch so detailed glimpses of the presence of water and gases we could only assume before. But with more to come, we are surely entering a new era for space technology and exploration. To everyone's utmost interest, NASA has selected SpaceX to launch the Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope on a Falcon Heavy rocket to study dark matter and more. When will it be launched? Why do we need another telescope after the $10 billion James Webb Telescope? How is it going to benefit space and science? Does it aim to do better than the James Webb Telescope, or does it all have different purposes? Let's find out. The news was released on several platforms, with SpaceX itself confirming it through its Twitter account. The post read, NASA has selected Falcon Heavy to launch the Roman Space Telescope, which is designed to study dark energy and dark matter, search for and image exoplanets and more. Liftoff is targeted for no earlier than October 2026 from Launch Complex 39A in Florida. But what is the Roman Space Telescope? Roman was previously called the Wide Field Infrared Survey Telescope, WFIRST. In many ways, the Roman Space Telescope can be considered a successor to Hubble, with a primary mirror measuring 2.4 meters, the same size as Hubble's. But it will have a huge field of view. With its wide-angle lens, it will be able to see an area of the sky about 100 times more than the Hubble could cover. The expected cost is around $3.2 billion, and NASA will pay SpaceX $255 million for the launch service and other mission-related costs, according to the agency officials. It will have a ride on a SpaceX rocket, the Falcon Heavy, which is a largely new rocket and has been used only three times before, most famously in 2018 with a Tesla-riding mannequin on board. But why Falcon, since it's an amateur among many? This could be due to the ability of the rocket to carry some extra fuel, because Roman will be flying to a distant orbit known as Lagrange 2, or L2, which is about 930,000 miles, 1.5 million kilometers, away from our planet. This is the same orbit that the James Webb Telescope uses and is relatively far away from Earth. But SpaceX may have had no competition for the Roman launch, since Tory Bruno, chief executive of United Launch Alliance, tweeted in February that his company was not bidding on the launch. NASA has regarded the mission as its top priority flagship mission from the 2010 Astrophysics Decadal Survey. In fact, the current decadal survey, published in November 2021, concluded Roman Telescope remains both powerful and necessary for achieving the scientific goals set forth in the earlier survey. The program was surely facing obstacles because keeping Roman on schedule and within budget is critical. NASA has to build up confidence that it can manage large science missions after the high cost and schedule overruns with the James Webb Telescope. It was denied its budget twice by the Trump administration until restored by the US Congress. The mission passed a major programmatic and technical milestone in February 2020, giving it the official go-ahead to commence hardware development and testing. It also passed its critical design review in September 2021, indicating that all design and developmental engineering work had been completed, and with SpaceX coming into the picture, we can see NASA is already past many hurdles. What will the Roman Space Telescope do? Roman is touted as the dark matter hunting telescope. It is because the primary goal set for the telescope is to study dark matter and dark energy and search for exoplanets. For those who are not very familiar, dark matter makes up most of the universe, and dark energy is referred to as the mysterious process by which the universe keeps expanding. On the other hand, exoplanets are planets orbiting other stars outside our solar system. For this purpose, it will undertake a galactic exoplanet survey. The wide-angle lens will help Roman map the Milky Way and other galaxies 100 times faster than Hubble. This will allow astronomers to see the environments around galaxies in the early universe. It is expected that Roman ultra-deep fields will be far more extensive than either the Hubble ultra-deep fields or even the first Webb deep fields. This is what we all look forward to. Not only is it assigned the task of finding thousands of exoplanets, but also rogue planets that there are way more of than the stars in the Milky Way, at least 100 billion. How will it accomplish this task? It will do so using an incredible technique called gravitational microlensing. Microlensing is what makes Roman so unique and special. It is due to this feature that astronomers will be able to find new types of exoplanets thousands of light years from Earth, orbiting stars near the center of the Milky Way. The concept is inspired by Albert Einstein's theory of general relativity and was proven during a total solar eclipse in 1919. Roman's incredible sensitivity will allow it to detect when the gravity of the stars and planets bend and magnify the light coming from stars that pass behind them from the telescope's point of view. It is similar to examining subtle warps in space-time induced by planets circling their parent stars. In addition to that, the Roman Space Telescope's coronagraph instrument, Roman Coronagraph, will carry out high-contrast imaging and spectroscopy of dozens of individual nearby exoplanets. A successful coronagraph technology demonstration, i.e. just meeting its technical threshold requirement, TTR, will be able to detect planetary companions 10 million times fainter than their host star and located more than 0.3 arc seconds away. This will surely act as a founding stone for many space missions. The telescope's main instrument will measure around a billion galaxies over its lifespan. In addition to that, the mirror of the Roman Space Telescope is coated with an extremely thin layer of silver, which is used because of its ability to reflect infrared light. It has a thickness of fewer than 400 nanometers, which is 200 times thinner than human hair. Who is the Roman Space Telescope named after? Does this question strike you too, as it did to me when they first changed the name of the telescope? Well, Roman is named after Dr. Nancy Grace Roman, who was an American astronomer. She served for 21 years and died in 2018. She's known as the mother of Hubble and is recognized for making the concept of the space telescope a reality. She headed up a committee of astronomers and engineers in the mid-1960s to work on ideas for a space telescope. She believed in the potential and practicality of the concept of a space telescope from the beginning. She convinced both NASA and the US Congress that a powerful space telescope should be a scientific priority. When James Webb was introduced for the first time, everyone who wasn't even linked too much to astronomy or space became interested due to the big claims NASA was making. And with the first series of images, we were actually glued to the screen and taken aback by both the beauty and mystery of space and the accomplishment of the telescope. Our social media became flooded with the images taken by the JWST, and every news channel was taking pride in announcing the dawn of a new space era. We surely have the same hopes for the Roman Space Telescope, and since NASA has listed it as their top priority, we can surely keep our expectations high. This was all from our side about the Roman telescope. Thank you for making it to the end. I hope you liked the video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Finally, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to receive regular updates from our channel.